91 here. So I stopped here before I got too far. So Google route, truck route GPS, does not always want to go the shortest distance. So technically, yes, I should have went north up 9 and caught 40 into Salt Lake. It was 11:56 over to Modesto. The GPS got me going clear down to Barstow and then 58 and then going back up. But all those miles at 55 or 60 in California would have took forever. That was actually 11:76. And if I'd actually get over here to Grand Junction and go north, or not Grand Junction, but Green River, Utah, and then go north on 6 to Salt Lake, it's 11:63, I think. It's a little bit shorter. But at the time, I could have went north and it would have been 11:56. So 11:56 versus 11:66, that's 10 miles. You know, nothing major for 10 miles. But I would have had, rabbit ears and then 40. 40 probably would have been just fine coming across. Now I got bail, and in 2 hours I got to stop and take a break. I should have done that when I was parked back there. Because now Vail Pass park, rest area is closed up here, or the rest area is closed. There might be parking at the truck parking lot though. But 2 hours, I should be able to make it over to Rifle. There's a rest area at Rifle, or I'll just park on the shoulder or something. Oh, I got Glenwood Springs to go through too. Still might be able to make it. I'm only half loaded right now. All the pipe is in the front half of the trailer. So that was copper back there. Now I'm climbing the east side of Vail. Side of Vail, it's 45 mile an hour downhill speed limit for trucks. I caught that flatbed again, that Western Star flatbed up here past me, top of the hill. Don't know where he's going. He's going home or what? I guess that first one that I caught was a Peterbilt, and the other one was a maroon Freightliner or Volvo. Maybe I haven't seen this Western Star. I thought I had, but maybe not. Just wet here. Of course, it's only 16 degrees as well. Another flatbed going north. I'm half empty. Conestoga. He's got his axle up. He's probably empty or half empty. I could probably put mine up too, but I ain't gonna take a chance. Let's see what the scale's reading. Nope, the scale ain't working on the trailer. Way running across down to Barstow and across 58 would have been 11:66, so that was 10 miles difference there. boss said, well, instead of having all those miles in California, why don't you go up 6 to Salt Lake and then run 80, which I can run faster. And then I'm not too much into California, back down to Modesto. It's just the simple fact that after I unloaded Modesto Thursday morning, it's going to be a backtrack back through to Sacramento to get to Anderson, and hopefully I can make it to Anderson and get that off as Thursday as well, so I can be in Lodi Friday morning.
Thank you.
y'all didn't catch that, I'm running 70 over to Green River, Utah, to go north on 6 to Spanish Fork, and then on into Springville, Utah, Salt Lake, catch 80, and then run 80 across Utah, Nevada, and California. I'll get to run faster across Utah and Nevada than I would California. There'd be most of these miles would have been in California. I won't have the big hill there in Utah, which actually I like. Not now, not no more. What a day from one day to the next day can do. Yesterday they had chain law up, I bet, most of the day because it's just snowing and snowing and snowing. And then by the time I got to Aurora and Denver, it was already melted off the highways and no chain law. In fact, there wasn't even a chain law when I looked at the co-trip when I was in Colorado Springs.